is my honor to introduce to you the president of Berkeley City College, Dr. Deborah Budd.
Thank you. Graduates, tonight we are celebrating your achievements. You have stayed the course on your journey to reach your educational goals. You recognize that education provides a way to propel you toward new opportunities that enable you to achieve your dreams. This year, the total number of 405 certificates and degrees are double the number that we had last year. And triple the number from 3 years ago. It is fantastic. These 405 certificates don't even include all of the 100 individuals that have received acceptance to UC Berkeley and the hundreds of students that are going to transfer to other UCs in the state, CSUs, public and private universities. We are so proud of you. Congratulations to you, your family and friends, and the dedicated faculty and staff who are here with us today, who have all contributed to making these graduation ceremonies not only a possibility, but a reality. Graduates, we are so very proud of you. The class of 2013 now has the skills to build trust, extend a helping hand, create bridges across cultures, and change lives. We are hopeful that your experience at Berkeley City College has helped you to develop the inclination to do good and the ability to do well, and that you are able to merge the two for a healthier community. You can bring significant and positive changes to our society. As new graduates, you can use what you have learned to build and strengthen community for others, and inspire those who have yet to travel the path that you now leave behind. As Steve Jobs said in a previous graduation address, your time is limited, so don't waste it living someone else's life. Don't let the noise of others' opinions drown out your inner voice. And most important, have the courage to follow your heart and intuition. They somehow already know what you truly want to become. Like many of us, some of you graduating today have experienced challenges and failures, but we are among good company. Taking risks can sometimes result in failure. Taking risks can also create opportunities. As so cleverly depicted in a recent short film developed by Dara Mollister, one of our very own multimedia art students, in his film titled Life Equals Risk, I'd like to share with you a few famous individuals who he identified as having risen above the challenges and obstacles. His film shares that Michael Jordan was cut from the high school basketball team and went and locked himself in the room and cried. That Thomas Edison was told by a teacher that he was too stupid to learn anything, and that he should go into the field where he might succeed by virtue of his pleasant personality. Walt Disney was fired from a newspaper because he lacked imagination and had no original ideas. Abraham Lincoln's fiance died. He had two failed businesses. He had a nervous breakdown, and he was defeated in 8 elections. Like those well-known individuals I have just mentioned, you have found that failure can be the steel forging fire that makes you stronger. Graduates, as you leave Berkeley City College, remember that continuous self-improvement, risk-taking, creativity, and striving for excellence are not skills that you develop, but are attitudes you embrace. Remember, do things right and do the right thing. Volunteer, you can make a difference in the lives of others. Create islands of excellence. They can be the positive turning point in a sea of change. And fill buckets of opportunity for yourself and others around you. We look forward to seeing you as new Berkeley City College alumni, creating a better world through continued service and sacrifice. Graduates, let your life-transforming experiences at Berkeley City College enrich the lives of your families, your communities, and the world. And now it's my pleasure to introduce to you Mr. Cy Galassa, president of the Peralta Community College District Board of Trustees.
I'm just looking over the crowd here. I know that when some of you have come before the Board of Trustees to speak, complain about problems, et cetera, we limit you to 3 minutes. So what I'm gonna do is limit myself to 3 minutes in response. And then like all of you do, I'm gonna go over a little bit, okay? So hello, Berkeley City College class of 2013, and hello to all you moms and dads, brothers and sisters, wives and husbands, kids, neighbors. You know, we have a wonderful full show this afternoon, an all-star cast of good-looking, very talented, and very smart graduates. I'm looking at them right now, and they're looking back at me. Hey! My name is Cy Galassa. I'm president of the Board of Trustees, and our job as trustees is to make sure that the 100 million tax dollars Peralta spends each year are invested in your success. That comes to about $40,000 to $50,000 for each of you if you've been here for your full degrees. Now, what did we do? We hired smart faculty and staff and leaders, and we built smart classrooms, and we filled them with dazzling technologies. And from the shining looks on your faces here this evening, we know we made a smart investment, and it was smart of you to take advantage. Now, make no mistake, you are stars today. Crowds will cheer you, adoring paparazzi will trail you, and your fingers will ache from all the handshakes. Expect bouquets, lays, parties, balloons, the pop of champagne, twitters of congratulation, and big hugs, and maybe a little cash from those special somebodies. This is your day. You deserve it big time. Let's look back a few years to learn the story of your incredible success, the fact that you're here tonight. Remember how as a kid you played a game called Connect the Dots? Did you ever do that? It has a whole splash of dots, and then you connect them, and maybe what happens, a dog comes into view, or a cat, or a flower, or something like that, and the dots are numbered. Well, I want to play a game like that with you tonight. Let's connect your dots over the past years, and remember, each dot represents a turning point, a decision, a reaction to an event, a reaction to a crisis, and a choice. When did you decide to go to college? Put a dot there. When did you choose a career? Put a dot there. Remember the frustrations of registration, applying for aid, getting classes? Put dots there, lots of dots. That first test you got an A, put a dot. Test you failed, put a big dot there too. And the semester you dropped out to get another job and pay the rent, a dot. And for midnight hours of study, more dots. And put dots for the counselors and instructors and friends and family who goaded and guided and inspired you at different times on your way. And put a dot for each course and semester and year you completed. And now, put a big gold dot for graduation today. Now look back and connect the dots. See how maybe they zigged here and zagged there and took a few sharp turns, but always moved steadily forward toward a destination? In spite of the turns, even U-turns, they all move forward in a line from that first decision you made long ago to your graduation here today. Congratulations. Note how, and this is very important, because you are not the same person you were when you began this journey. Note how along the way you gained self-confidence and self-discipline and acquired new liberating ideas and skills. Yes, You've come a long way across the years, and you made great connections. Now, when you wake up tomorrow, and the balloons have gone flat, and maybe the dishes are still in the sink, and the dog is eating the leftover cake, look ahead to the future. Notice there are no dots. You are on your own. What kind of dots will you put in that blank future? Dots for more college, for success in business, for wealth and power, for love, for travel, for enlightenment, for schools, for community. Dots for greening the earth, for healing, teaching, creating. Dots for justice. Dots for equality. Now, as you begin this new momentous journey, choose well and choose wisely. And remember, in spite of inevitable twists and turns, connect all your stars and dream and trust yourself. Let the rush of excitement, of pride and amazement and accomplishment you feel today, tonight, carry you far, far into a distant future full of wonder and success. Congratulations and good luck, Berkeley City College Class of 2013.
Thank you, Trustee. Now, to give us greetings from the Associated Students of Berkeley City College is President of ASBCC, Mr. Ethan Creasy. Please give a warm welcome to Mr. Ethan Creasy.
Hello, graduates. I'd like to say congratulations to y'all. This is an incredible moment, what you have achieved. It's time to move on to your next step. Whether you came here to Berkeley City College to advance your career or move on to another institution, your time here is done. What you have achieved is very, very important. And it wasn't easy what you have done. It took a lot of hard effort and persistence. It forced you to stay up long nights some nights. Forced you to cram on the bus before you came to class. You've overcome many obstacles, stressing over grades, stressing over tests, enduring long finals, trying to figure out what the essay prompt even meant in the first place. And finally, also a lot of catching up on your favorite TV show instead of doing the studying that you needed to do. And dealing with the stress that eventually caused, anyways. So, congratulations on seeing your efforts rewarded. I wish all y'all the best of luck in the future. Thank you for your time.
It is my pleasure to introduce Dr. Jose Ortiz, Chancellor of the Peralta Community College District. His leadership and strong commitment to our students, our faculty, our staff, has inspired us all to continue to transform the Peralta Colleges into one of the finest community colleges systems in the nation. Let us welcome Dr. Jose Ortiz, who will present the Chancellor's Trophy Award.
Good evening. It's my distinct pleasure to first, acknowledge the graduates this evening. I want to congratulate you on your accomplishments, knowing full well all the hard work and the obstacles you had to overcome to be here this evening. About 35 years ago, the Peralta Community College District Board of Trustees created what we know today as the Chancellor's Trophy. Each year, each of the four Peralta Colleges nominates a student for the Chancellor's Trophy based on their scholastic achievement, their citizenship, leadership, and service to the community. With this in mind, Berkeley City College nominated for the Chancellor's Trophy Mr. Christoph Andrew Green. Christoph is a psychology major. And Christoph is a psychology major and will continue his studies in psychology, and he will be transferring to Cal Berkeley. Christoph has been involved at Berkeley City College as a student ambassador, a student senator, has worked in tutoring basic skills, and has been a member of the Civic Engagement Club. He's received scholarships from the Peralta Association of African American Affairs, the Jerry Adams Berkeley Community Fund, and the Oakland Center for Spiritual Living. Christoph has overcome personal family tragedies, educational and economic challenges to stand before us today. And BCC was instrumental in changing his life. Christoph has demonstrated perseverance, tenacity, resourcefulness, and commitment to excellence as he has transformed his life and has inspired others. Today he graduates with a 3.9 GPA. Christoph, I want to congratulate you on your accomplishments, and I want to grow up to be just like him. Let's give it up for Christoph.
Wow. I'm speechless, and if you know me, that's fairly rare. The only thing I can think that's appropriate to say is just thank you from the bottom of my heart, not just for this, but for everything that it symbolizes. And this isn't just for me, this is for everybody that has worked hard, that has seen struggles and obstacles, and here we stand anyway, here we are today. Just want to say, we made it, you guys. Here we go.
I'm passing on to Christoph his award. It includes a cash award, so he's taking us all for lunch. Hey.
Wow. Congratulations. Let me thank you.
Congratulations. Thank you, Chancellor. Now we have some brief entertainment that we are just thrilled about. Performing a poem they wrote to reflect the educational experience at Berkeley City College are Miss Chloe Merrifield and Miss Nuseba Abdul-Karim, accompanied with background music played by Mr. Edwin Lobato.
Fall, part one. It's my second year after high school. I left university, the oversized classes, the feeling that I didn't belong, not to start over, but to change direction. I've left behind friends, entering a place where I know no one. I'm nervous. I don't know whether this is right, this college here on Center Street.
Hands held to the heavens, open to knowledge, or a metal book that will crush me with its weight. Above the entrance, a new doorway in my life. I dragged my questions through the shivers of excitement and the knots of fear towards the admissions office. The first one in my family to start higher education, I had little guidance. Besides encouragement, my mother's confidence in me, nothing to prepare me for the language barrier I found when I landed at the foot of the admissions office. They spoke the language of bureaucracy, endless paperwork. I spoke with the tongue of a soul still untethered from the grasps of capitalism, homeschooled without an official signature. I had so many questions, confusion-laced uncertainty, no one to translate the forms for me.
Fall, part two. Without knowing, I've fallen into place, unexpected friendships made. For such a small campus, there is a largeness of minds and hearts, of people who say yes to whatever they undertake. The working mother, those already with full-time jobs, looking for something more. Those who had taken a class nowhere else before. The teacher who never gets enough credit. And all those else whose lives have weaved with mine.
I smiled, nodded, and signed my way to the classroom. Prerequisites, electives, transfer requirements. For the first time, I didn't call my teacher mother or my classmate sister. Deadlines and due dates seared imagined trenches into my forehead. I carried a GPA in my backpack, its weight pushing me down, pressure I thought I couldn't bear.
Spring, part one. The community in this college, best expressed in the classroom, where words fly like paper birds, and creativity seen in every face around, in the help and praise and friendships given. None of this could have been anticipated, yet all wanted, all welcomed.
I was a yo-yo crashing to the ground, but the flick of an unseen wrist pulled me back up. For the first time, I was forced to face my fear of not being perfect, doing something I had always wanted but never dared, writing. Somewhere a light turned on, I could see a direction I wanted to go, a voice I wanted to share. The earth was no longer shaking. My mother, who used to be my teacher, started school, became my classmate. Together, we wrote late-night papers, shared information on classes. The walk to school grew into a sixth sense, and experience grew beyond the classroom. Basement events, club meetings, financial aid lines.
Spring, part two. And now I'm leaving, but I won't forget who I was before I came. That taking risks is often the best way to learn. That who I am now cannot be understood without this place, at this time, without these people.
The time nears for me to exit, enter another doorway, with a foundation for the rest of my education, the ghosts of a couple of trees, some silver hairs, but it was well worth it. Knowledge is a rose that one must climb a thorny stem to achieve, but the bloody palms don't take away from the sweetness of its smell.
Thank you.
And we thank the faculty that helped them be motivated to write that poetry. Speaking of faculty, this year's Faculty Senate greeting comes from Aline Young, Chair of the Counseling Department.
Hello, graduates. Well, this is what it's all about. The hard work and sacrifice has brought you to this point, success. Doesn't it feel good? The fact that you set your goal, kept your eye on the prize, and emerged victorious. I encourage you to set goals in all areas of your life. It is a fact that successful people typically have several goals in process at the same time. Why? Because we are multidimensional entities with several areas of interest that require attention, assessment, scrutiny, and improvement. Set your goals high, graduates. Reach for the moon. And know that if sometimes you don't actually grab the moon, you will gather stars. You've set a standard for yourself. You know that you are capable intelligent individuals. From this point on, nothing less will do. On behalf of the faculty at Berkeley City College, I want to thank you. Thank you for your efforts. Thank you for your persistence and determination. And congratulations, class of 2013.
Well, education is definitely a team effort. It's the students, the families, the friends, the faculty, and the staff that are all involved. This year's classified Senate greeting comes from Ms. Fatima Shah.
Graduates, it is my honor to congratulate you, your family, and your friends on behalf of Berkeley City College classified staff. Today, we celebrate your academic success and your hard work that got you to this point. As you move from this point, as you move from this milestone to the many others that await you, and you look back at your journey, I am sure you will remember Berkeley City College has a unique learning community where the diversity of our students make us rich and the enthusiasm of our faculty, staff, and administrator inspire us to keep on track. As Thomas Edison said, the secret to success is focus and purpose. As you leave Berkeley City College as a new graduate and to your next endeavor, go with focus and success, because today prove that hard work and determination truly leads to rewards and accomplishments. As a classified staff and former Berkeley City College students, I would like to say thank you to all the classified staff, because they are vital to your success. They go above and beyond to ensure that you have the resources and support to be focused and purposeful in your journey here. As a classified staff, we are privileged to have had the opportunity to support your educational journey and are very proud of your accomplishments. Congratulations, class of 2013.
This year, we are proud to recognize our valedictorian, Genesis Matthew B. Sanchez. Dr. Mei Chen, Vice President of Student Services, will introduce Mr. Sanchez, our 2013 valedictorian.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, girls and boys. It is indeed my pleasure and my honor to introduce one of my students' staff members here, Genesis Matthew B. Sanchez. Today, with GPA at 4.0, he's graduating with associate degree in arts and humanities. And after today, guess where he's going to? Here. So here you are. Genesis, go ahead.
Before I begin my speech, I want to thank the faculty, professors, my family, my friends, and Christ my God. You are the dots that have made my life a picture. So let's give each other a round of applause. We did it. I remember thinking to myself in high school, forget college, I want to become a famous actor. Looking back on this, I realized just how wonderful we people can be. Or wonderful because what we can do, who we are, and who we can be fills me with so much awe. We're also pretty wonderful because we are also very unpredictable. Because here I am, standing here, humbly receiving this honor, which obviously means I haven't forgotten about college. And second, here I am standing, and I'm not a famous actor. Now, speaking of this honor, I asked myself these two questions while I was preparing for this speech. What should I say, and how should I say what I'd like to say? Essentially, I am a fellow student, and this means I'm on the same journey that many of us are on. It's a journey to live as best as we can, to do something with ourselves, to be truly alive. So, seeing my place in life, I realize that the best thing to do is to reflect with you, to share something with you that has been of such use to me, and I hope that what has helped me may help you too. If there's one thing that has refreshed my spirit and has made my brightest days even brighter, it is humanity. It is the humanity that's nourishing and filling every moment, every place, every person, everything. It lifts me up when I'm down, and it helps me carry on even through my most excruciating points in life. For example, I've been in the Berkeley bubble for so long that I have been brainwashed into wanting to become a philanthropist. I'm just kidding. I actually want to do philanthropical work out of my heart most of the time. The beautiful thing about the word philanthropy is it means love of humanity. However, in reality, I find that that which I cannot stand the most, that which I want to run away from the most, and unfortunately, that which I hate the most at times is humanity itself. However, when this stuff happens, I ask myself, boy, what else does philanthropist mean but lover of man? Where is your love? Love is everywhere. Where are you? A pure heart can thrive in the darkest abyss. I barely even scratched the surface. Why am I crying? So, when I remember something like this, I realize that every person, every relationship is a place, no matter how stormy it is, to find, to experience, and to cultivate the oh-so-human virtue of love. And when I realize that, I find the strength to find heaven within my darkest abyss, and I find the strength to reach for the love without which any sort of philanthropy would be impossible. Finally, humanity brightens my day. When I experience anything inspiring, such as us graduating, such as a breakthrough in art, science, or any other human endeavor, or even the simplicity of nature, or even people merely living life, I remember the Indian proverb, Tat Vam Asi, you are that. To behold these things is to behold humanity, our true nature, who we are. So, such are just a few ways of how humanity lifts my spirit and puts a smile on my face. Now, there's something I'm guilty of not doing, something bad enough that if I did it on a philosophy paper, I would get an F. I have not given you a definition of humanity. So, what is humanity? Well, in my experience, it's a true heart, a beautiful soul, a soaring spirit, something divine. Now, some of you may have a problem with this. Some of you may say, that definition doesn't contain humanity. To that, I respond, good. I also have a problem with that definition. In fact, I don't think any words can contain humanity, who we are. What we are is beyond words. The human spirit is boundless. It can only be fathomed by the divine. The human heart has wings beyond words. Its flight is everlasting. Such has carried me through my most trying times. Such as open up the world to me and giving me wings like eagles. Such as like the wind blowing everywhere and like the light shining upon everything. So if there's any truth in my words, I hope you gain the wings to soar too. Or as my grandma tells me, take wings and fly. Thank you.
And now our keynote speaker. Tonight, we'd like to welcome Dr. Lisa Dyson, Chief Executive Officer of Cavardi, a breakthrough firm commercializing a proprietary biological process that upgrades waste carbon into high-value chemicals. Dr. Dyson has conducted research in bioengineering and physics, including energy research at Stanford University, University of California, Berkeley, Princeton University, University of California, San Francisco, Massachusetts Institute of Technology, MIT, and the Lawrence Berkeley National Laboratories. She earned her PhD in physics from MIT, where she conducted research in string theory. She was a Fulbright Scholar at the University of London, where she received a master's degree in physics with an emphasis in quantum fields and fundamental forces, and also holds degrees in mathematics and physics from Brandeis University. Hearing this, I think you'll find out why she was named one of the top 40 under 40. Dr. Dyson has a diverse background in management, business consulting, technology, development, and scientific research. She has experience in a number of industries, including transportation, travel, automotive packaging, telecommunications, and energy, and was a management consultant with the Boston Consulting Group. Dr. Dyson enjoys building and leading entrepreneurial teams to develop new technologies. She has been awarded a number of honors in connection with her technical work. Please join me in giving a warm welcome to our speaker, Dr. Lisa Dyson.
Thank you very much, Dr. Butt, for that warm introduction. And thank you as well to the Board of Trustees, to Mr. Gulasa, and also to Dr. Ortiz. So I am excited to be here and celebrate with you the class of 2013. Congratulations on all of your accomplishments. So before I start, I'd like to do a little exercise, so bear with me. I'd like to ask each of you to look around the room and count the number of items that are red. Red items. Just quickly look around. There's some beautiful red dresses I see. Okay, great. Now stop. So close your eyes quickly. How many items are green? So if you're like me and like most of us, it was very difficult to think of the number of items that were green. In fact, by focusing on the red items, we lost sight of all of the other possibilities, of everything else. So, in a way, we put ourselves in a box, a red box. A red box that limited our perspective, so that we didn't see the other possibilities in front of us. Not only did we miss the green possibilities, but we missed the yellow and the blue and the orange possibilities as well. So I see this as an analogy for life. We often put ourselves in boxes. Sometimes these are the boxes that society has created for us. Other times, these are the boxes that our families have created for us. And even the boxes that we build ourselves can constrain us. While these boxes may surround us, nothing is actually preventing us from stepping outside of these boxes, from seeing the other possibilities. So staying inside a box can be useful on occasion. For instance, if you're carving out your career path, or you're focused on passing that philosophy final, or even if you're trying to count red items. But it limits our ability to see what else is there. That's why we have to take a leap sometimes. We have to soar. We have to step outside of the box and look at it, and then look around. Only then can we see the world for what it really is. It is a place that is full of countless possibilities. When I was growing up, I quickly learned the value of stepping outside of boxes, of seeing the other possibilities both in my life and for my life. My parents, who loved me dearly and very much supported me, they separated when I was only 3 years old. When I was growing up, I moved back and forth between parents, from mother to father to mother to father. And on top of that, my parents moved a lot. So as a result, by the time I was 14, I had attended 14 different schools. This could have created a few boxes in my life, a box of instability, a box of uncertainty perhaps, or even a box of self-pity. But I didn't let any of those boxes confine me. Instead, I chose to be empowered. At the age of 14, I decided that I had entered my last school. I decided that no matter how many times I moved, I would graduate with the same group of people with whom I had entered high school. This decision required me to, at times, wake up at 4 o'clock in the morning to catch a bus from the new home that I had moved to get to the school that I had vowed not to leave. I did move a few more times throughout high school, but I did not change schools again. I graduated with the same group of people with whom I had started high school. So I chose a different reality. I chose to see the box for what it was and to step outside of it. I chose another possibility. And I say to you, to all of us, as we go through life and circumstances try to confine us, choose not to be confined. Choose to break out of the box and enter into the world of countless possibilities. In recent years, I have focused my attention on a different box. A box that is a box in society, a big red box of environmental destruction. So did you know that Americans throw away enough paper and plastic cups, forks, and spoons every year to circle the Earth 300 times? Americans buy 30 billion plastic water bottles every year, and 8 out of 10 of these end up in a landfill. That's 24 billion plastic water bottles ending up in landfills. Did you know there's a huge pile of waste that is floating in the Pacific Ocean? And the area of this is estimated to be twice the size of the continental US. We have a waste problem. As you know, we also have an addiction to petroleum. Petroleum is used to make so many of the items that we use every day, from carpet to fabrics to plastics, and of course, fuel. So what if we could think about both waste and fuel differently? What if we could break outside of the box of environmental destruction and choose a new possibility? What if we could use waste, the waste that we create, as a resource, as an energy-rich raw material that we could use to make fuel? And guess what? We can. And that is what I focus my life on doing with my company, Converti. So we're working on an innovative technology that can take the waste generated in almost every sector of society and turn it into the chemical building blocks that can be used to make everyday products, including fuel. It is a technology that literally recycles waste into fuel. And we use microbes to do it. These microbes eat the waste and make all this happen. So in essence, one organism's waste is another organism's fuel. So while waste may seem like one of society's biggest problems, it can also be one of our biggest solutions. We are breaking out of society's big red box of environmental destruction and seeing a possibility that was there all along, a green possibility. So this example of breaking out of a societal red box and pursuing a green possibility can lead to the innovations that will fuel the future. So in a similar way, it is through your own ability to break out of the boxes in your lives and the boxes that society places on us, you can reach for the possibilities beyond them, the countless possibilities. You can gain power, the power to fuel your own futures. There's a great quote that I love by Gandhi, and it goes like this: "A small body of determined spirits fired by an unquenchable faith in their mission can alter the course of history." The thing that I want to leave you here with today is that you are the body that can alter the course of history. You, the graduating class of 2013. Sitting here today as honored graduates of this fantastic institution, you've already begun to leap out of various constraining boxes. You've already revealed to yourselves and to others a whole new world of academic, professional, and creative possibilities. The degree you will receive today furnishes you with the tools to break out even further and to realize the missions that you want to develop for yourselves, the missions that you have for society. I've made it my mission to break our societal box of environmental destruction, to break out of that box. So what is your mission, class of 2013? What boxes will you tear down? And what possibilities will you uncover for yourselves and for the world? And just like those green and yellow and blue items in this room, the possibilities are countless. They come in so many different shapes and so many different places. All you need to do is see them. See the possibilities you've never seen before. Congratulations on your accomplishment.
Thank you, Dr. Dyson. Well, now is the moment you have all been waiting for. Yes. Will Dr. Mei Chen, Vice President of Student Services, and Lilia Selhay, our Dean of Instruction, please come forward.
The candidates for degrees and certificates in the program and also the program inserts of Berkeley City College, would you please stand up and remain standing?
President Budd, on behalf of the faculty and staff at Berkeley City College, it gives us great pleasure to present to you the candidates for associate degrees and certificates, and we ask you to welcome them into the company of college graduates.
By the authority vested in me by the Peralta Community College Board of Trustees and the Board of Governors of the State of California, I confer upon you the degrees of Associate in Arts, Associate in Sciences, Certificates of Achievement, and Certificates of Proficiency.
Genesis Matthew Sanchez. Christoph Green, Associate in Arts and Transfer Degree in Psychology and Certificate of Achievement in Liberal Arts with highest honors. Tamaris Renzande, Associate in Arts Degree and Certificate of Achievement in Business with honors.
Anand Stefan, Associate in Arts Degree in Liberal Arts, Social and Behavioral Sciences with honors.
Karima Shamur, Associate in Arts Degree in Business with honors. Did you read her name? Jamla Nasser, Associate in Arts Degree in Liberal Arts, Social and Behavioral Sciences.
Rose O. Lebog, Associate in Arts Degree in Liberal Arts, Social and Behavioral Sciences, transfer to San Francisco State.
Shalina M. Baker, Associate in Arts Degree in Liberal Arts, Social and Behavioral Sciences, with high honors, transferring to San Jose State University. Rebecca Jacquez, Associate in Arts Degree in Liberal Arts and Humanities in Liberal Arts, Social and Behavioral Sciences, and Certificate of Achievement in Liberal Arts, IGETSE, with high honors, transferring to UC Berkeley.
Komel Virk, Associate in Arts, Transfer Degree in Business and Certificate of Achievement in Liberal Arts, IGETSE, with honors, UC San Diego.
I gotta read that one. You got it. Larry McDaniel, Certificate of Achievement in Liberal Arts I get the UC Berkeley.
Amora Denise Brown, Associate in Arts degree in Liberal Arts and Humanities.
Yay! Lynn Palmer, Certificate of Achievement in Computer Information Systems.
Congratulations.
John Palmer, Associate in Science degree and Certificate of Achievement in Computer Information System with highest honors.
Yes. Donna Lanise Ayel, Certificate of Achievement in Liberal Arts IGETSE, CSU, General Education Breath, and Multimedia Arts.
Mariano Castillo de Souza Rogedo, Associate in Arts degree in Spanish.
Julia Garcia, Associate in Arts degree in Spanish.
Okay. Hihanska. Hoki Sheila. Hey, me. Associate in Arts degree in Liberal Arts and Liberal Arts Social and Behavioral Sciences.
All right, it's that time. BCC graduates of 2013, please join me in moving your tassels to the left. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Please remain standing for the national anthem. Mr. Charles Boomer. Mr. Boomer.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed as the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, nor the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave? or the land of the free.
Have mercy. Please have a seat. That was a great rendition. Good afternoon, President Ambrice Galaviz, members of the Board of Trustees, Chancellor Dr. Jose Ortiz, esteemed faculty, administrators, staff, family, and friends, and most importantly, the class of 2013. My name is Dr. Eric Gravenberg, Vice President for Student Services, and I am honored to welcome Merit College's 2013 Commencement Program. This year, we have over 800 students graduating. 862 to be precise, and it makes me so happy. All of the faculty and staff are so excited and very proud of your accomplishments.
We will start with our Honorable Abel Guillen, Vice President of the Peralta Community College District Board of Trustees.
Wow, this is a good looking group. Congratulations, graduates. Welcome to the achievers, to the leaders, and to the dreamers of the class of 2013. Welcome parents, families, community members gathered here today to honor your success. On behalf of the Board of Trustees, I'd like to thank you all for supporting your graduates and thank you for your support of public education. Because of you, Merit College changes lives. And this class of 2013 is proof of that. Yes, today is the culmination of lots of hard work, right? And for all your hard work, we will be giving you a piece of paper. Yes, it is a piece of paper, but that paper is a degree, your passport, if you will, to Cal State East Bay, to UC Berkeley, to a new career. Indeed, it's a piece of paper, but more than that, it's a passport to the world, because from Merit, you can go anywhere. As you may know, Merit is steeped in tradition of activism, academics, and athletics. You may know that the Black Panther Party was born here at Merit College. But did you know that nurses trained at Merit College have passed the rigorous nursing board exams at high rates, higher rates than a lot of private schools? I'm talking about a 95% passage rate and at a fraction of the cost than those private schools charge. And let's talk about and acknowledge our men's basketball team, who had a storybook season this year, making it all the way to the Final Four. We all know that the road to Merit is not easy. Neither was getting to graduation. You braved hardships and stresses, waited and waited for financial aid checks, not getting the classes that you needed because of budget cuts, missed the 54 bus. Anybody miss the 54? Some of you may have even gotten in trouble at work because you were doing your homework while you were supposed to be working. But in the end, graduates, you prevailed. Your faculty and your classified staff here is a world-class bunch, and they could be teaching anywhere, but they decided to teach here in Oakland, in the community, to transfer their knowledge to you, and they deserve a round of applause. It took some of you 3 years, maybe 4 years, maybe 5 years to get here today. But I leave you with this old, this African proverb, calm seas do not make good sailors. Let me repeat that. Calm seas do not make good sailors. In life, you find rough seas, and you use your perseverance, your optimism, and your belief in yourself to navigate those waters. We need you to use that passport to change the world, to build a better tomorrow for all of us. And lastly, don't forget to exercise your right to vote and your civic duty. I wish you Godspeed and congratulations.
Now, Dr. Taysoon Park.
Good afternoon, everybody. Fellow family, friends, faculty, staff, administration, and guests. We are here to welcome the graduating class of 2013. Graduates, be proud of yourself. And you have all worked so hard and achieved your goals, including passing the last math class that you postponed to take for a while. Thank your family, friends, and whoever helped you to get here. Today represents a new beginning. You may transfer to a four-year university or find a job with your new certificates or degrees. Whichever path you choose, have the courage to follow your dream, your passion, your heart, and intuition. Always be willing to take risks and never doubt yourself. Be persistent, be sincere, and keep your personal integrity. Whatever happens, do your best and move forward, and amazing thing will happen. Have faith in you and who you are. Friend, faculty, staff, administration, and guest. Let us give a hand to the graduating class of 2013 and the families. Thank you all.
Our classified Senate President, Molly Celan.
Welcome, family, friends, Board of Trustees, Chancellor Ortiz, President Ambriz Galaviz, faculty, staff, and of course the students. Here at Merritt College, we're here to celebrate the commencement of spring 2013. My name is Molly Celan, and I'm the Classified Senate President, and I'm here to help celebrate your success and your accomplishments, and to help you take pause for this wonderful celebration. As everyone has said already, we've faced some serious challenges in order to get here today. You students had to find the campus, and then you had to find the classes that fit your needs. The faculty had to redevelop courses to fit the needs of you all and attach the student learning outcomes that make graduates relevant to the job market, as well as an asset to the community in which you live. So thank you to the faculty. The administration, who was challenged to keep these doors open and to ensure a quality education for those who need it most in our community. Thank you to the administration. Lastly, I want to thank the classified staff who were challenged to provide students, faculty, and administrators, and each other, service under severe budgetary restrictions and the lowest staffing levels this campus has ever seen. So thank you to the classified staff. And I want to make sure to include all the volunteers who worked so hard and tirelessly to make this event happen today. Thank you to those students and staff. We are now so proud to come to this point in time and celebrate what we have all accomplished. And this is made more possible under the new leadership of our Chancellor, Dr. Ortiz. His motto for success is, do the right thing and do things right. Sorry, I stole that from you. So thank you to all the faculty, the staff, the administration, your work in getting us here today. Every graduation is special, and this one may be more so. With helping students, I rediscovered a quote from a leader, one who found his voice after much hardship and struggles, a self-educated man who was killed in the prime of his life, but whose message will live on in each student who reads his story. His words are, "The future belongs to those who prepare today." So the future belongs to those who prepare today. That's Malcolm X. That being said, preparing for the future is never easy. What is coming? We can't know for certain. So you must do your best to plan and be prepared to adapt. Mother Nature is one of our best teachers. And if you're in a place where you thrive, stay there, carry on. However, if you find that the conditions are not right, for whatever reason, maybe folks aren't helping you. Maybe there's not enough options. Make the adjustments and move on. There are no easy solutions. So in conclusion, you reap what you sow. Go out in your community and share your knowledge. Keep learning. Be open for change and recognize your own success. Congratulations, the class of 2013.
Now I have the pleasure of introducing our Associated Student Body President, Shanae Anderson.
Greetings, family, supporters, significant others, mentors, and friends. On behalf of the Associated Students of Merritt College, I welcome you to the 2013 Commencement Ceremony. To the Merritt College graduating class of 2013, today is the day you finished what you set out to start. And I know we look so good out here with our caps and gowns. I have to let the people know it was not easy. Day in and day out, tired, exhausted, sometimes happy, sometimes sad. Some of us looking like a bag of money, and some of us wishing we had a bag of money. We stormed into classes, full or not, all for one goal, the development of ourselves and to graduate. We have faced adversity and lived through chaos. Pursuing higher education in Oakland is no joke. There are many things, good and bad, happening to cause distractions. But graduates, those things did not distract you. You kept your eyes on the prize, and today you win. Graduating is not to be taken lightly. We have prevailed, we have overcome, and we have conquered. In graduating class of 2013, you have arrived. To our supporters and advocates, Martin Luther King said, "Occasionally in life, there are those moments of unutterable fulfillment which cannot be completely explained by those symbols called words. Their meanings can only be articulated by the inaudible language of our heart. Although there may not be a word to express how we feel about you, or a present we can afford to buy you to show our love and appreciation. Without you, who knows where we would be today? And for that, we give thanks." I'm gonna end with a poem that everyone can understand. You have brains in your head. You have feet in your shoes. You can steer yourself in any direction you choose. You're on your own, and you know what you know. You are the man or woman who'll decide where to go. Congratulations, graduating class of 2013.
Well, hello out there. Sinead, thank you so much for your inspirational words. And you know, from the time that we've spent together, I really do appreciate working with you as your Associated Student President. Thank you so much for doing that. And also for having such inspirational words to your graduating class of 2013. Well, here you are at this big event. You ready? As your interim vice president of instruction, and along with my colleagues, faculty, classified staff, and managers, I am so proud to be awarding the degrees and certificates in recognition of the accomplishments of the class of 2013. Academic tradition requires that we recognize students who distinguish themselves by achieving highest honors of scholarship in the graduating class. These individuals are honored having achieved the highest academic grade point average of 4.0. It is now my honor to acknowledge these two students, these achievers of the merit class of 2013. First up is your salutatorian, Sui Jin Chu. Based upon her bio, she was born in Myanmar, Burma, in 1991. She has a brother and two sisters, and she's the youngest in her family. Throughout her life, her parents have shown not only her, but her brother and her sisters the power of education. And they have always wanted to see their children succeed. In order to have a better education and a better future, her parents migrated to the United States in 2008. She was 17 when they arrived in the United States and had an opportunity to complete her high school. She went on to Oakland High for 2 years and with no hesitation decided to attend a community college afterwards. The decision, because both of her parents are not working, my mom is disabled and my dad is too old to get a job, she therefore, for four of us, worked to support the family. Also, she wasn't ready to go on to a four-year university right after high school, so she had been working at Sullivan Learning Center since 2009. She started as an instructional assistant and later became a lead instructional assistant. Recently promoted as office manager. At Sullivan, she learned a lot of new skills and also to improve her public speaking and communication skills. Currently, having been working on her Associate of Science degree, she will be attending San Francisco State University this fall, majoring in biochemistry. She wants to be a pharmacist and work in the pharmaceutical field. She is so glad to be chosen community college. She is glad that she chose community college to pursue her education. The best option for people as herself, she feels, is a community college before going on to a four-year college. That way she could take care of her family. It gives me an opportunity to work and support my family while fulfilling her own goals. She believes that education is the key to succeed, and no matter who we are or where we come from, we all can possess the key to open up our future if we have strong desire, determination, persistence, and perseverance. Congratulations, Sui Jin Chu.
Thank you.
Okay. We are also honoring your valedictorian, who also happens to be the recipient of the Chancellor's Trophy Award. Therefore, it is my pleasure to introduce our Chancellor of the Peralta Community College District, Dr. Jose Ortiz.
Thank you very much. Good afternoon, everyone. And in name of the Board of Trustees, the faculty, staff, administrators of all four Peralta colleges, I want to lend my voice and our voice to congratulate the graduates from Merritt College 2013, to recognize your accomplishments, and to wish you well as you move forward. Many years ago, the Peralta Board of Trustees and the Chancellor decided to recognize the top students for each college through what we're called the Chancellor's Trophy Award. Each college was to consider their top students, nominated by students and by faculty, to those students who exemplify high achievements, scholastic work, citizenship, leadership, and community service. With this in mind, the Merritt College trophy goes to Alba Lopez Nidia. Alba is a liberal arts major, and her professional goals are to continue her interdisciplinary studies and pursue work in education as an advocate for the disadvantaged and underrepresented. Some of her Merritt College activities include serving in the Altasor Peer Advisor, working with the Puente program as a tutor, working with Building Futures for Women and Children, and working with Girls Inc. as a tutor and reading coach. Alba has achieved academic honors and is a member of the Phi Delta Kappa Honor Society. She has overcome great personal and academic and economic challenges to stand before us today. She is an inspiration to all of us, to all of our graduates and her peers. She is graduating, as you heard, with a 4.0 GPA. And she will be transferring to UC Berkeley to return. As the Merritt College recipient of the 2013 Chancellor's Trophy, Ms. Lopez is being presented with a monetary award of $1,000. And an engraved gift that she can take home and remember her experience here at Merritt College for years to come. We congratulate Alba for her success, her accomplishments, and wish her the best of luck as she continues her pursuit in excellence. Thank you very much.
How you doing, Alba?
Good, thank you.
On behalf of the staff, once again, I'd like to present the valedictorian medal to Alba Lopez. Congratulations.
Hello, everybody. Good afternoon and welcome. Faculty, administrators, parents, and guests. It is an honor to be here as valedictorian representing the graduating class of 2013. You know, when I When I got the call from saying that I was valedictorian, I couldn't believe it because I've been through some very difficult times. So I had to, I actually had to listen to the voicemail like 10 times to realize that, you know, I was actually valedictorian. So first of all, I want to start off with a story. So if you will permit, I would like to share this story with everyone. This is a story of a young girl who came from her country at the age of 9, along with her mother and her oldest brother, to meet with her father, who she hadn't seen for years. After her arrival, she was enrolled in school, but she didn't speak English. So for a whole year, she had to take special classes, but within that year, she learned how to speak English fluently. Time passed, and she moved on to junior high school, and eventually to high school. When she got to high school, however, like for many students in inner city schools, it wasn't easy. Instead of having 6 or 7 classes, she only had 3. And instead of having instructors, most of the times, she had security personnel. At the time, this young girl didn't know what was going on was illegal. Nobody should have to go through what she went through. When her mother found out what was going on, she immediately went to the school like any other concerned parent would do. When her mother got there, nobody spoke English, so she couldn't get any help. Eventually, she got a call from a counselor who spoke Spanish and gave her an appointment. Her mother went and spoke to that counselor, and she said, "What can I do for my daughter?" And he gave her 2 options. The first option was to go off to a program called Job Corp. So he explained to her what Job Corp entailed. He said, well, she's gonna leave on Monday mornings and she's gonna come back on Friday. So then her eyes opened widely and she said, wait a minute, she's gonna live there? He said, yeah, she's gonna live there. So her first question, as any concerned parent of a 16-year-old, said, is it COVID? He said, yes, it's COVID. So she decided that her daughter wasn't gonna go. So at the so then he said, well, her other option is to drop out of school. She can drop out, wait till she's 17, and continue on to adult school. And so she did. At the age of 16, that young girl dropped out. I'm sorry. That young girl was me. So this is why today it is such an honor to represent all of you. I know that each one of you graduates that sits here today has also gone through a lot of personal stuff to be here today. So I want to congratulate each one of you and say, you did it. You are here today. We've all had sleepless nights, haven't we? Writing papers for professors like Ms. Santana, Professor Foster, Professor Johnson, and Professor Duran, and many other professors who gave us a lot of work. So today, I say we celebrate this collective achievement and we give ourselves a round of applause. So as we look around, we are each reminded that this would not have been possible without the many wonderful people that supported us through this journey. So in behalf of the graduating class, I would like to thank the Merritt College faculty, staff, professors, counselors, And of course, our friends, families, husbands, children, and everybody who supported us in this journey. Thank you. I want to personally thank Professor Duran for believing in me and for giving us Altasor, which has helped me and many other students who are present here today transfer to a four-year university. Thank you. I would also like to thank our transfer counselor, Tanya Ilarde. Thank you so much for supporting us, Tanya. Helping us through this difficult transfer process would not have been, I don't think it would have been possible for me if she wouldn't have helped me the way she did. Thank you very much, Tanya. And last but not least, I would like to thank a very, very special professor who I love and admire, Professor Santana. From the very first day I met her, her passion, love, and dedication inspired me. You have helped me each step of the way, and I am very thankful for everything you've done for me. Thank you, Professor Santana. I also want to thank my parents and my husband for their endless support. Ma, pa,
gracias por todo. Por todo el amor, por las enseñanzas, y por enseñarme a ser fuerte y tenaz, o como diría mi mamá, a ser terca.
Finally, a mi esposo. Honey, I love you. Thank you so much. So, my plan was actually not to get all emotional, but this is an emotional event. Because today, we are saying goodbye to many beautiful and wonderful people. And because today, our journey at Mary College ends. But let us not see this as an end, but as a new beginning. Because now, I believe that the foundation has been laid and that we have all acquired the necessary skills and tools to take our next step in life. Some of us will be transferring, others will be enjoying new careers and new jobs, but whatever it is, I know that a world of opportunity awaits us. So let's celebrate this joyous day. Thank you.
Let's again congratulate our Chancellor's Trophy recipient and the valedictorian and salutatory of your class. Many of the students being honored here this afternoon already have received various scholarships and awards. Merit staff and students celebrated these achievements at the annual awards banquet. The banquet was held this year on Friday, May 10th, 2013. Those who receive scholarships or awards, please stand up and be recognized at this time. We are extremely proud of your accomplishments. Oh, come on now, you can give a better hand than that. Graduates and guests, in your commencement program, you will notice small stars next to some of the names. These stars signify the honors that you have received based upon their accumulative grade point average. Graduates receiving honors earned a 3.25 to 3.49 GPA and have one star next to their name. Please stand and be recognized at this time. those of you with a 3.5 through a 3.74 GPA have two stars next to your name and have received high honors. Please stand and be recognized at this time. Those of you with a 3.75 to a 4.0 GPA have three stars next to your name and have received highest honors. Please stand and be recognized at this time. You will also notice that some of the students are wearing gold stoles and tassels. These students have a grade point average of 3.5 or higher. Some of these students are members of Phi Theta Kappa International Honor Society, the Beta Theta Lambda chapter of the two-year colleges. Now you know it's your time to stand and be recognized. And then finally, all students with a 3.25 or higher grade point average are also wearing gold stoles and tassels. Now I would like to call back President Ambrise Galavis for the introduction of our guest speaker. Sorry about that.
It is with great pleasure to introduce our 2013 commencement speaker, Robert L. Harris, Esquire. Robert Harris is an individual that you will be very proud to have met and will want to meet with him after our ceremony here. He is an individual that graduated from Merritt College, a Merritt graduate success story. He went on from Merritt College, and he also, just to remind you, he also is a graduate of Oakland Technical High School. He went on after Merritt to San Francisco State University. From there, he actually was inducted to the San Francisco State University Hall of Fame in 2007. In 1972, he received his Juris Doctorate degree from the University of California of Law at Berkeley, Bolt Hall. He was an associate editor of the California Law Review and published two articles in the review. He was admitted to the California State Bar in December 13, 1972. When he graduated, shortly after he graduated, he joined the legal staff of PG&E and practiced law there for 17 years. He handled a variety of legal matters before transitioning into the business side of the corporation. In 1985, he became the first and only lawyer in PG&E history to argue and win a case in the United States Supreme Court. In so, he became the first lawyer in the nation to convince the Supreme Court that a corporation, like an individual, had negative First Amendment rights. He is a Merritt College success. He subsequently was elected within the PG&E organization as an executive assistant to the PG&E president, and therefore elected vice president of the Environmental Affairs Officer. He retired recently, and as retiree, after 34 years in this company, he still was able to maintain a significant leadership role in our community. He distinguished in numerous endeavors and is a recipient of countless awards from across the nation. He is a resident of Oakland, and he is married to Glenda Newell Harris, MD, and is father of 4 children and grandfather of 6 grandchildren. We are honored to have him with us today with our graduating class of 2013.
Madam President, thank you very much for that introduction. If my mother were alive and here today, she would agree with everything that you said about me. To the Chancellor, to the Board of Trustees, to the faculty, to the staff, and most of all, to the graduates. Graduates, you deserve a round of applause. I am deeply appreciative of this opportunity. When I enrolled in Oakland City College, now Merritt College, I had no idea that this institution would be the linchpin for all that I have achieved or may have achieved. As a lawyer, as a corporate executive, and as a community advocate. Besides my family, there are 3 pillars that have guided my life, and they are education, hard work, and community advocacy. First, education. It was the late Barbara Jordan, U.S. Congresswoman, who said, education is still the key to political, social, and economic power. Without the key of education, there can be no political, social, or educational power. Your theme, Merritt College, we change lives, has special significance for me because it was here where I embraced confidence after being told by my counselor in 1960 at Oakland Technical High School that because I had come out from Arkadelphia, Arkansas, in a segregated rural school that I could not enroll in college prep courses. I enrolled anyway. I found a way. There was no way that this counselor was going to kill my dreams. I was motivated by the admonition of Marcus Garvey, the Jamaican liberator, who said, if you have no confidence in self, you are twice defeated in the race of life. But with confidence, you have won even before you have started. Many of you, I am sure, may have entered Merritt College with some trepidation, perhaps a little voice softly whispering, are you sure you want to do this? What if you flunk? Well, I too heard that voice as I entered Merritt, but I, like you, ignored that voice. Look around you. You sit on the mountaintop of achievement, recognizing that you now have the foundation to succeed in whatever you have chosen to do. I graduated from Merritt in 1963, and in the words of R&B artist R. Kelly, thinking that I could fly, even reach the sky. Today, you have enormous opportunities, regardless whether you leave here and journey to your chosen career, or whether you elect to continue your academic endeavors as I did. But either way, today is a great day for you. The second pillar of my life is hard work. Hard work is the equation upon which the restless thrives and transforms obstacles into opportunities and success. Thomas Edison put it bluntly and succinctly, quote, "There is no substitute for hard work," end quote. Some people I know, and you probably know some too, spend an inordinate amount of time moaning and groaning about how hard they work. What a waste of precious time. They should just get over it. Frederick Douglass, who correctly noted that, quote, "People might not get all they work for in this world, but they must certainly work for all that they get," unquote. There is no free lunch. Having spent 34 years at PG&E, let me share with you just the one short story that was mentioned by the president. In the 1980s, consumer groups decided that they should be allowed to put materials in the PG&E monthly billing envelope. Many states across the nation had ordered utilities to do this. And when California ordered PG&E to do it, I said, no, that is unconstitutional. Virtually every legal scholar in this nation said that I was crazy. And of course, PG&E said so too. But they let me pursue it. After 2 long years of some of the most intense work in my life, I found myself on October 8, 1985, standing before the United States Supreme Court arguing the case. To the surprise of legal scholars, but not, of course, no surprise to me, the United States Supreme Court ruled in my favor. It was an historic moment for me and for PG&E. The lesson of this story is that as you climb the ladder to your next station in life, whatever that may be, never let anyone convince you that you cannot reach the unreachable. The only limits on your ability to achieve are those that you impose upon yourself. Always remember the melodious voice of that singer of yesteryear, Curtis Mayfield, as he sings, "We're a winner," and never let anybody say you can't make it, because we're moving on up. As you march across this stage in just a few minutes, don't forget that in the lyrics of R. Kelly, you are stepping in the name of love for merit college education. The final pillar, community. Lois Gibbs got it right, and I quote, "Average people and the average community can change the world." Regardless what we may achieve in life, we do not stand as islands isolated from our communities. Rather, we stand on the shoulders of those who made it possible for us to be here. We owe them an endless debt, for we are benefactors of this prodigious community college and are obligated to give back to it and our communities. That is why education and hard work are essential components of our community values. For it is written in your theme, merit college changes lives. The question I submit is, how do we change lives? The answer, of course, is we do so in innumerable ways. Each of us must discover that passion within us for community service. Throughout my life, I have tried to live up to the words of Khalil Gibran. In his book, The Prophet, he says, "It is when you give of yourself that you truly give." As I conclude, I must say that returning to Merritt College as your commencement speaker is one of the highlights of my life. For it was here that I took my first step onto the highway of higher education. Today, you step in a world of global opportunity that will ignite your thirst for not only dreaming, but achieving the impossible. Whether you leave here today embarking upon a career or navigating the waters of higher education, you must leave with a level of confidence that will distinguish you as Merritt College graduates who change lives. Thank you very much.
Mr. Harris, could you step up to the podium again? We would like to thank him. Our success story, again, continues. And he had just shared some wonderful, inspirational words. And with that, we want to recognize your time here with us. So again, in sincere appreciation, Merritt College hereby acknowledges your commitment to the highest standards of excellence through the framework of social justice and education. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Graduates, now is the time.
Entering the stadium, the 2013 Laney College graduates. Once again, please welcome the 2013 Laney College graduates. Ladies and gentlemen, our mistress of ceremony, Ms. Denise Richardson, president of the Laney College Academic Senate.
Please stand for the national anthem performed by internationally acclaimed artist, Mr. Lawrence Beeman.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, who brought stripes and bright stars through the perilous flight? O'er the rampart we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night. And our flags were still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free? And the home of the brave. God bless you.
I would like to extend a warm Laney welcome to our honored guests, trustees, Chancellor Ortiz, Vice Chancellors, President Webb, distinguished faculty and staff, family and friends, and of course, the graduates of 2013. Thank you all for being here today. This year's graduation theme is looking forward to a new quality of life. Today marks a new beginning with newfound success. It is also a fresh opportunity to create new goals and to begin planning for the rest of your lives. Today, you will be recognized for your accomplishments and challenged to go even farther by many of the individuals who helped to keep Laney College moving forward. With that said, please join me in welcoming the Honorable Cy Galassa, President of the Peralta Community College's Board of Trustees.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And good morning, everyone. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Thank you. It is a good morning, and it deserves a good celebration. So hello, Laney College, class of 2013. And look out there in that crowd, and hello to all you moms and dads and wives and brothers and cousins and kids and neighbors. Hey, we have a wonderful show this afternoon, or I should say this morning. It'll probably go on to the afternoon with so many graduates here. This is an all-star cast of good-looking, very talented, and very smart graduates. You know, my name is Cy Galassa, and I'm the president of the Board of Trustees. Now, I know a number of you students and also faculty in the crowd occasionally have come before the Board of Trustees to either congratulate us on wonderful performance, but most often to complain just a little bit about what's happening. And what we usually do is limit you to 3 minutes, although once in a while you go over it a little bit and somebody will stand up and say, wrap it up, wrap it up. So I have a little speech, a few comments this morning. It'll go for 3 minutes, but if I go over, Vice President Guillen is going to stand up and say, wrap it up, Galassa. So here goes. You know, our job as trustees is to make sure that the 100 million tax dollars Peralta spends each year are invested in your success. And from the shining looks on your faces this morning, We know you took good, very good advantage of our investment. And make no mistake, you're stars today. Crowds will cheer you. Adoring paparazzi will trail you, and your fingers will ache from all the handshakes. Expect bouquets, lays, parties, balloons, the pop of champagne, twitters of congratulations, big hugs from all those special somebodies, and maybe a little cash. Let me repeat that, a little cash. They heard. You know, this is your day. You all deserve it big time. Now let's look back a few years to learn the story of your success. Do you remember how, as a kid, you played a game called Connect the Dots? Any of you remember that? Numbered dots were scattered on a page, and when you connected number one dot with a crayon to number two and so on, a drawing eventually emerged. It might be just a kitten or a little puppy or a flower. But what we're going to do this afternoon or this morning is to connect the dots over your past few years so you can see what pattern emerges. Each dot represents a turning point in your lives, a choice you had to make. When did you decide to go to college? Put a dot there. When did you choose a career? Put another dot there. And remember the frustration of registration, applying for aid, getting classes? Put some dots there. That first test you got an A? Put a dot there. The test you failed? Put some more dots. And the semester you dropped out to get a job? Put a dot there. And for the midnight hours of study, many, many dots. And put dots for the counselors, for the instructors, friends and family who goaded and guided and inspired you along the way. And put a dot for each course and semester and year you completed. And now put a big gold dot for graduation today. Congratulations. All right, now turn around, look back, and connect the thousands of dots. There were literally thousands of decisions you made, some small and some very big. See how maybe they zigged and zagged, took a sharp turn, and even moved backwards at times, but see how together they all move slowly and steadily forward from that first decision you made so long ago to your graduation today. Now, note how along the way, the zigs and the zags grew smaller as you gained self-confidence and acquired new liberating ideas and skills. The picture that emerges today is not that of a child's puppy or kitten, but a portrait of a strong, determined, focused, and seasoned winner. Congratulations, class of 2013. By learning to connect the dots, you discover just who you are and what you can accomplish. Now, when you wake up tomorrow and the balloons have gone flat, and maybe the dishes are still in the sink, and the dog is eating the leftover cake, get up and look out the window on the future. Notice there are no dots, no counselors to guide you. You're on your own now. What kind of dots, what kind of stars, what kind of hopes will you put into that blank future? Dots for more college, for success in business, for wealth and power, for healing, for teaching, for justice, for equality. Now remember, anybody can put dots or goals or dreams in their future, but only a few, like you, know how to connect them. So as you begin this new momentous journey, choose well and wisely, and remember, in spite of inevitable twists and turns, connect all your dots and stars and dreams and trust in yourself. Let the rush of excitement and of pride and amazement and accomplishment that you feel this morning carry you far into the future, a future full of wonder, surprise, and success. Congratulations and good luck, Laney College class of 2013. Remember, always stay connected.
This commencement ceremony is dedicated to the memory and families of the 6 students who passed away this academic year. Their names can be found on page 2 of your program. Please pause with me for a moment of silence in their memory. Thank you. Now, if you would, please join me in welcoming our esteemed, our own Dr. Jose Ortiz, Chancellor of the Peralta Community College District. He will also be administering the Chancellor's Award. Thank you.
Good morning. My pleasure to be with you this beautiful Saturday morning. On behalf of the Board of Trustees, the faculty, staff, administrators of all four Peralta colleges, we want to lend our voice of congratulations and recognition to our graduates for their accomplishments and their future success. At this time, I want to share with you the award of Chancellor's Trophy, which is given to a student from each of our Peralta colleges, recognizing their scholastic achievement, their citizenship, their leadership, and their service to our community. This year, for Laney College, the Chancellor's Trophy Award goes to Mr. Brian Cervantes. Brian is a social science major. He's also a veteran from the US Navy. He aspires to be a history teacher. He has demonstrated leadership not only as a student, but certainly as a citizen. He was instrumental for the Peralta colleges rallying a student march in Sacramento when the district was facing deep budget cuts. He also has served as a student trustee on our Board of Trustees, has been very instrumental in student leadership at Laney College. The Chancellor's Trophy comes with a $1,000 cash award. Brian is graduating today with a 3.64 GPA and will be transferring to Cal State East Bay to continue his studies. Congratulations to Brian.
Congratulations, class of 2013. You made it. Today is your day. Representing the Faculty Senate is truly one of the greatest honors of my professional career. Having worked closely with your instructors over the past 11 years, I have come to realize that not only are they talented and competent, but they are also among the most passionate and caring individuals that you will find anywhere. Please join me in recognizing and thanking the faculty members of our college for all that they do to make Laney College rock. To our students, I say thank you for allowing us to be a part of your educational journey. This day makes it all worthwhile. The long nights, grading, your very brilliant work, I might add, preparing our lectures, the countless emails exchanged on how we can improve upon your success, and of course, the meetings, upon meetings, upon meetings. In this moment, as we look out into your beaming faces, I think I can speak for all of us that it is time very well spent. Sharing information with you and helping to prepare you for your futures is the best job ever. We live in a world that has expanded exponentially over the last couple of decades. Due to advances in technology and communication, our influence and contributions now have global reach. Not only are we citizens of our respective countries, but in the words of our own Dean Marco Menendez, we are citizens of a global community. Today, we challenge you, as well as ourselves, to strive for excellence as we all work together towards stronger, healthier, local and global communities, where differences are celebrated, violence as a means of resolving conflict is passé,
and mutual respect and regard become the norm. We honor you, we believe in you, and we look forward to the phenomenal accomplishments that we know will be yours. Seize the inspiration of this proud day, bask in it, internalize it, and let it move you forward as you realize your dreams and goals. Remember, success is ongoing and is measured best by what you do for others. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Faculty Senate President Denise Richardson.
Please join me in welcoming my colleague, James Blake, President of the Laney College Classified Senate.
Congratulations to Laney Class of 2013. It is my honor and privilege as Laney College Classified Senate President to address this body on behalf of the classified staff. I would like to share a quote with you from Islamic poet Ramdi. He says, "On a day when the wind is perfect, the cell just needs to open and the world is full of beauty. Today is such a day." End quote. As classified staff, we look forward to the completion of our time with us. It's indeed a time of great appreciation and celebration, a thing of beauty. We have enjoyed the journey that you have made to reach this day. For this day is the completion of our service to you, class of 2013. As you start looking forward to a new quality of life, ponder the words of Romney once more. He says, "Don't be satisfied with stories, how things have gone with others. Unfold your own myth." End quote. I encourage you to continue your unique success, whether you enter the workforce or transfer to complete your education. Good luck, and may God bless you. And as Ziggy Marley says, be true to yourself. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Classified Senate President James Blake.
Thank you, President Blake. Now, please join me in welcoming your student representative, Melissa Cervantes, president of the Associated Students of Laney College.
Hello, Laney College. How are you today? I just want to start by saying that I'm really proud that my mom, my dad, and my sister, and my cousin, they're here from Tijuana, Mexico. They travel all the way here to see my husband and me be participant of this. So mom, dad, I love you. So good morning, Board of Trustees, President Webb, faculty, staff, platform guests, parents as well as other family members, friends, and above all, the graduation class of 2013. It is indeed an honor to stand in front of you as your current student body president. My name is Melissa Cervantes. Today is a very special day for the class of 2013. On a personal note, it is a very special day for me because my wonderful husband, Brian Cervantes, who's dedicated his academic life to the needs of the students here at Laney College, is graduating today. Let's give him a round of applause. This may be an end of a great journey for some of us. However, for all of us, this is the beginning of a great future. Just 3 years ago, I was sitting on my graduation at UC Berkeley. I remember sitting there, and I began to think about all the sacrifices that I had to go through to enjoy that moment. I became so wonderfully overjoyed that I began to cry. I cried because I was happy. I cried because I saw my parents' faces and how proud they were when they saw the first member of our family to ever receive a college degree. I cried because my husband was with me in the most difficult time of my life. I cried because I had hope for the future, just like you have today. Because you have reached the first milestone of a never-ending journey of reaching your goals and achieving your dreams. Although this year was very challenging for all of you sitting on these seats today, and at times it felt like it was never going to end. However, we're here all today celebrating our accomplishments on this great occasion. As you remember the hard times and struggles that you have to go through, remember the lessons you have learned along the way. Remember, you're stronger today than you were yesterday. And more importantly, you achieve your goal today as graduates of Laney College. Thank you. Honestly, today you should be proud of yourselves, of your achievements and accomplishments. Be proud of your dedication and commitment for your future. And be thankful that you're still alive sitting in these chairs with an opportunity to achieve a higher goals for yourselves, whether it's transferring, going to work, or volunteering in your communities. For some who started this journey with us and are not here today, may we give them a moment of silence in honor of them. Someone once said to me, getting your degree or obtaining your degree is not necessarily about how smart you are, but it's a test of endurance. So here we are, class of 2013. Give yourselves a round of applause for enduring this journey. Consider this day a blessing. Once again, congratulations, class of 2013, and may the force be with you. Thank you.
Thank you, President Cervantes. Now we have a special treat for you, a dance performance by none other than the Laney College Dance Department. Tracy Henson will be performing a piece choreographed by our own Jacqueline Burgess.
Your children, and don't let them fall by the side of the road. And teach them to love one another, that heaven might find a place in their hearts. 'Cause Jesus is love. He won't let you down. And I know He's love forever. We've got to walk on through temptation, 'cause He's love and His wisdom will be our helping hand. Lift up our hearts to be thankful and glad that Jesus is love. He won't let you down. Thank you.
And now we will have a brief presentation of the Laney College Lifetime Achievement Awards and our Community Leaders of the Year Awards presented by our esteemed Executive Vice President, Dr. Stephen Cohen.
Good morning, everyone. That's what I like to hear. On behalf of the president and the community of Laney College, it gives me great honor to present the Lifetime Achievement Awards to members of the Laney team whose years of service and unwavering dedication have made a substantial impact on our community. Please read their summary biographies, which are included in your program. The first Lifetime Achievement Award goes to Mr. Robert Fleming for his years of outstanding service in the Laney College Financial Aid Office. Please join me in congratulating Mr. Robert Fleming. Our next Lifetime Achievement Award goes to Ms. Iris Brooks for her many years of service in the Laney EOPS Department and Laney Counseling Department. Join me in congratulating Ms. Iris Brooks.
Congratulations.
The last Lifetime Achievement Award goes to Ms. Loretta Hernandez for her lifetime devotion to the College Cosmetology Department, Puente Program, and Counseling Department. Loretta passed away this year, so please join me in a brief moment of silence in honor of her memory. Thank you. And now, we would like to present our Faculty of the Year Award to Ms. Amy Bohorquez, the Laney Curriculum Committee Chair and Biology Faculty. Please congratulate Amy Bohorquez. There she is. Next, we'd like to recognize the classified staff. Oh, yes, give Amy another hand. She's great. Now we'd like to recognize the classified staff of the year, Mr. Antoine Mayole, our Senior Campus Information Systems Analyst. Please join me in congratulating Mr. Mayole. These individuals have contributed in profound ways to our educational excellence and student success at Laney College. Please join us once again in congratulating Bob, Iris, Amy, Loretta, and Antoine. Finally, we are very happy to present the Student Leader of the Year Award to Mr. Brian Cervantes. Brian is a student trustee and a member of the 2013 Laney graduating class. Brian epitomizes excellence and integrity. His commitment to a high quality Laney and Peralta Community College District leaves an extraordinary legacy for all of us. Please give a warm round of applause again for Mr. Brian Cervantes. Wow. Now I have the honor of introducing several other exemplary students from our Laney class of 2013. I'd like to begin with the winners of the 2013 Dean's Medallion Awards. The Dean's Medallion is a Laney College Award given to five students of exemplary academic and community service achievements. As I call your names, please stand and remain standing until I call all five medallion winners. Brian Cervantes. William Escobar. Talitha McAdams. William Ramos Ochoa. And Shana Wakia. There she is. All right. Please join me in another round of applause for our 2013 Dean's Medallion winners. Stay there. Don't sit down yet. Next, I'd like to have all the students who were awarded a scholarship at our honors and awards banquet this year to please stand and join them. Everybody that got a scholarship and were at the awards dinner? Okay. Oh, we got a few more than that. Come on. Great. Let's give them a hand. Well done, students. You may be seated. Congratulations to all of you. Thank you.
Now, please join me in welcoming our Laney College president, the esteemed, the extraordinary, Dr. Elnora Webb.
I saw a wonderful image on my way here this morning at 6:30 in the morning. It was gold. It's the same image I see now, you. Solid platinum gold. You soon to be Laney College graduates. I am so proud of you. You enrolled, you engaged, you learned, you achieved, you are succeeding. Thank you, so many of you. I could name a number of you. You were active participants in the teaching as you shared remarkable insights, knowledge and skills in your classes with instructors and students and outside in the corridors, in the quad, in classrooms, on the football field, on the tennis courts, the basketball courts, and many, many more areas of this campus, including our instructional labs. You and the entire 2013 graduating class challenged us, the professionals of Laney and throughout this district, to make even more rewarding the conditions and qualities of this fine and ever-improving institution. You engaged heavily in the life of this college, in a diverse array of events and successful performances over the last 2 years, such as the jazz and music series, the dance, the theatrical performances, Cinco de Mayo, Dia de los Muertos at Oakland Museum, Echo Fest, the CTE Career Days, African American Health Summit, the Laney Eagles Women Track Team won state last year, and our baseball team won the Bay Valley Conference this year. I can go on and on and on to include the Manufacturing Reshoring Conference with hundreds of people here, the Asian Pacific Islander celebratory events and seminars. I can go on. You inspire teams of faculty, classified staff, and administrators to carry out the type of efforts that has rendered Laney College a national center for the National Science Foundation. You've taken advantage of internships with hundreds of local employers, including BART, governmental agencies, the County of Alameda, hospitals, Chevron. You made certain that we understood your needs to ensure that we could provide efficient transition from foundation skills courses to college level certificate and degree programs, and so you're here. You chose to invest in you In doing so, you acquired new knowledge and skills. Most importantly, as part of that, you strengthened your capacity and increased the odds that you will exceed your own self-affirming expectations for your careers and lives. And of course, you've done much more. So many of you are now ready to pursue careers in fine dining, in the broad area of cosmetology, building automation, performance and energy efficiency, construction trades, industrial manufacturing, biomanufacturing, management and supervision, medical device technology, IT, court interpreters, digital media, and so many other fields. Likewise, many of you are prepared to transfer to the University of California campuses. A number of you I know are going to Berkeley, Davis, Santa Barbara. You're also prepared to go into East Bay, CSU campus, San Francisco State University, Sonoma State University, and a host of private four-year colleges, including Stanford University, I didn't mention Mills College, Holy Names, St. Mary's, and Patton University, to pursue your bachelor's degrees and more. Whatever your plans, you made certain that you could be present here today. Yes. And now many of you have committed to developing a sustainable focus on promoting peace. Peace throughout the city of Oakland, so that generations of individuals get to experience the extraordinarily rich environment. You're doing this by volunteering to help children, assuming career positions with businesses and community-based agencies to serve the underserved, by inspiring youth and young adults to pursue college and university studies, by providing rewarding alternatives to what we know to be, unfortunately, violence and disrespectful engagement by too many, and most importantly, by participating in initiatives that improves the quality of homes, neighborhoods, and businesses. You are the solutions we need. Already this city is replete with so much value, yet the beautifully diverse people of this city and greater Bay Area require your contributions, the best of you, your learnings, your understandings, your skills, your expertise, your genius. You are the hope. Your achievements help to improve lives. You, thank you in advance for doing the obvious, for committing your life to serve, even if only you know how your actions serve the greater good. As part of ensuring a more welcoming, healthy, and productive society, continue to think in healthy ways, interact with good intentions, behave respectfully, act with integrity, foster the sharing of resources, and remember, we need one another and we need this planet. Likewise, disrupt the status quo when it is harmful to the well-being and progress of our nation and global society. And be mindful to provide solutions, alternatives to enhance conditions in sustainable ways. And as your program notes, and we've already conveyed, this ceremony is dedicated to the memories of the lady students who transitioned this year and their families. Because of their legacies, we are establishing scholarships in their names to support Laney students. Thank you, Peralta Foundation. We will announce details via the Laney College website by next month. In recognition of you, the class of 2013, we're establishing the Laney College Student Leadership Development Program to nurture generations of students to become active and effective civic leaders and contributors to the cultural fabric of the East Bay. And further, fall 2013, we are launching the college's Professional Leadership Institute for faculty, staff, classified staff, as well as administrators to ensure excellence is replete throughout this college. This is part of the college's commitment to all of its employees as they value quality and effectiveness in serving generations of students. Finally, I am honored to join our Board of Trustees including led by our President Sy Galassa, Chancellor Jose Ortiz, the balance of our trustees, executive colleagues, college faculty, administrators, and staff, and certainly the students who will continue here in salutation for your accomplishments. Congratulations, class of 2013.
At this time, I'd like to welcome to the podium Frances Allison, the valedictorian of the Laney College class of 2013.
Good morning. I just learned that Frank Oz, the voice of Fozzie Bear and Yoda, is a Laney graduate. I don't have any Yoda-like advice, though. I am humbled to stand here with you. We're all very powerful today. I feel it. I just want to say to use our powers for good and not evil. We've all worked really hard to get here. Looking forward, it's going to be how we choose to apply that work that will matter most. I'm going to call on everyone here, even everybody up in the stands too, to be a volunteer this year. Whether you're helping out in an elementary school, cleaning up a park, or even coming back here to Laney to tutor. Let's show Oakland that Laney leads, and let's shoulder the burden of making tomorrow better. We've been afforded plenty of powerful tools to help us do this work, but we need to get started. We can't just look forward to a new quality of life without continuing to keep putting in the same amount of work as we did here at Laney. It might even take more. So, whatever it is you're gonna do, that dream you have that you came to Laney to develop, keep working on it. Don't say, hey, I worked hard, I'll party for a week and then I'll go change the world. No, because this world won't wait for us. Don't get me wrong, tonight is for celebrating. Finally, it's our instructors and the Laney staff that helped us to develop these tools that we're going to use. For instance, Ms. Stiegel and Ms. Talbot for taking their time with Sarita Millette. Also, Chefs Jones and Jackson for helping Willie Hampton. All of us come from different places. We have different passions and we have different paths laid out before us. But we all today, all of us have thank yous. On behalf of my peers, I want to say thank you to the Peralta Colleges. Also, thanks to our friends and family for being here with us. Personally, I'd like to thank my brother and my parents for their inspiration, and my beautiful fiance for the support and patience I've needed to get here today. And especially my fellow classmates for the great times we've had here at Laney. Thank you, and congratulations to the class of 2013.
Now it is time for the commencement address. Please join me in welcoming our keynote speaker, Attorney Barbara Parker, Esquire, City Attorney for the City of Oakland.
Good morning, everyone. I'm delighted to be here today on this another beautiful day in Oakland. And in its honor, I'm honored to be here at this special time in your lives. If you were expecting President Obama, you probably can tell by now that I'm not him. That means you're very observant, but we do have a lot in common. We both went to Occidental College, Harvard Law School, and we both grew up on the Pacific Ocean. In fact, we're basically the same person, except that he's only the President of the United States. And I have the more important job of being the city attorney for Oakland, California. Don't tell him I said that. I want to give my thanks to Chancellor Ortiz, Dr. Webb, Board President Galassa, members of the faculty, staff, and the Board of Trustees. And I want to thank especially you, the graduates, and your family, and your friends who are here to savor this important moment. You have passed a major milestone today. We are here to celebrate you and to congratulate you on this wonderful accomplishment. As a graduate of Laney College, you join an illustrious group of people who mark generations of students, young and some not so young, who have graced this school and gone on to fame and fortune. This school is nationally renowned. And it has forged new pathways for us to enrich our quality of life. The ceremony, I'm sorry, I have a little bit of a cold. The ceremony is called a commencement because it is the beginning of a new phase in your lives. It's not the end of your learning. And it's the beginning of moving forward to examine what could be a better and should be a new quality of life. You worked hard, you've struggled, and you've sacrificed, and you've overcome many obstacles to be here today, which builds character and strength. I believe that the most important lesson that you have learned, as it's been for me, is the skill to know how to continue to learn and to continue a lifetime of learning and expanding your horizons. Whatever career you choose, I believe that the most important skill, thank you, you will have is this ability to continue to reinvent yourself and to continue to examine yourself. As you know, the theme of today's commencement is looking forward to a new quality of life, which raises, in my mind, profound questions. And it reaffirms my strong conviction that we must always examine, re-examine, and reflect on what truly matters and what truly has value. This introspection will guide us as we embark on our careers, face challenges, experience successes, and overcome failure and tragedy. Ultimately, each of us has to determine what constitutes a quality of life and what it means to strive and look forward to a new quality of life. For me, it means, of course, having enough money for clothing, food, shelter, and of course, a little discretionary money to have fun. But most importantly, it means being true to my values, my integrity, treating others as I would like to be treated, and making contributions to our community. The slogan we always use of giving back. In my case, it means working as hard as I can to be the best mother, daughter, grandmother, lawyer, and city attorney for Oakland, and to continue the fight for justice, for an equal playing field, and to end discrimination in our society. Yeah. My goals spring from my experience and the time that I grew up in, and I think I have a number of peers in that regard. I was born before the Supreme Court handed down the famous decision in the Brown versus Board of Education outlawing segregation in schools. I was also the product of parents who grew up in the segregated South as sharecroppers and poor farmers. They sought a new quality of life by moving to Seattle, Washington, on the Pacific Ocean, where I was born, and to give me and my siblings a chance at a better life. Their lives, like all of ours, were filled with struggle, triumph, and tragedy. For the younger people here, it may be difficult to remember that in our lifetime, segregation was a law of the land. and it was the same in parts of Seattle. At age 12, a couple of friends and I attempted to desegregate a segregated lunch counter in Woolworth's basement in Seattle. We weren't successful, but it began a lifetime for me of knowing that we have to stand up and fight. So I'm very grateful to my parents for instilling me a lifetime of love of learning. Like many of you, I am the first generation in my family to go to college. And when I was growing up, it never occurred to me that I could be an attorney. It wasn't even within my horizons. I tell you this because people will tell you as you go through life, you can't do this, you're too old to do that, you don't have the wherewithal to do this. And I've never been a person who accepts what society tells us we can do or can't do. To guide yourselves. Goodness. The fact that you are here today demonstrates that you have the skills and the ability to move forward. No matter what you do in your lives or where you go, we all have to answer the fundamental question of what are we looking forward to? What does quality of life mean? Does it mean having money? Does it mean having a family? Does it mean having the strength to learn and grow and accomplish what is important despite fear and adversity? And as we celebrate, we also must think about those who are not with us today, who are honored today, and the violence that has become part of the fabric of our society. What does the quality of life mean in a city with the epidemic of violence that we're suffering from? What does it mean to look forward to a future when so many of our friends and brothers and sisters are robbed of their future? It's a difficult and perhaps an almost impossible question. But I believe, in the words of Dr. Martin Luther King, that the arc of history, while long, bends toward justice. And as long as we continue to work hard and believe in the future, we will be successful. So, ultimately, the question of what makes the quality of life worthwhile for you is a personal one, and one that only you can answer. But I urge you to make service to others a critical component of your quality of life. There's the old adage that it takes a village to raise a child. And it took a village to get us here, and none of us will get anywhere in life on our own. We stand on the shoulders of our parents, our friends, our community, and our ancestors. So I ask today that you don't stop thinking deeply about what a new quality of life means. What it will mean to you 2 years from now, 10 years from now, 20 years from now, and some of you may be here 100 years from now. Today, I know you're bursting with pride, as you should be. Take time to celebrate and revel in this milestone and relish looking forward to a new quality of life. I am honored to be able to share these moments with you. Congratulations, class of 2013.
Sorry? So you need to.
Janet and Jackson.
Hello, everyone. How are we today? All right, now, I want a little bit more than that. This is the end of the semester. You are graduating. On behalf of the faculty and the staff and the graduating students and our faculty, I would like to welcome you to the 2013 commencement ceremonies for College of Alameda. All right, you can show some emotion here. It is now my pleasure to introduce our president of our board, Trustee Cy Galassa, for a few words for the graduating class.
Hello, College of Alameda class of 2013. And hello to all you moms and dads and brothers and sisters and wives and husbands, kids and neighbors. We have a wonderful show for you here this afternoon. an all-star cast of good-looking, very talented, and very smart graduates. Yeah. I told you, and you see, they're so smart they recognize themselves when they're... My name is Cy Galas. I'm president of the Peralta Board of Trustees, and our job as trustees is to make sure that the 100 million tax dollars Peralta spends each year are invested in your success. And from the shining looks on your faces this afternoon, we know you took good advantage of our investment. Now make no mistake, you're stars today. Crowds will cheer you, adoring paparazzi will trail you, and your fingers will ache from all the handshakes, and expect bouquets and leis and parties, balloons, the pop of champagne, twitters of congratulation, cash and big hugs from all those special somebodies. I'll repeat the word cash in case some of the somebodies missed it. You know, this is your day. You deserve it big time. Now let's look back a few years to learn the story of your success. Remember how as a kid you played a game called Connect the Dots? Any of you remember that? Numbered dots were scattered on a page, and when you connected number one dot with a crayon to number two and so on, a drawing emerged, a kitten, a flower, a dog. So let's connect your dots over the past few years. Each dot represents a turning point, a choice you made, a decision. When did you decide to go to college? Put a dot there. When did you choose a career? Put a dot there. And remember the frustration of registration, applying for aid, getting classes? Put some dots there. That first test you got an A, put a dot. And the test you failed, put some more dots. And the semester you dropped out to get a job, another dot. For the midnight hours of study, more dots. And put dots for the counselors, the instructors, the friends and family who goaded and guided, inspired you along the way. And put a dot for each course, semester, and year you completed. And now put a big gold dot for graduation today. Now, look back and connect the thousands of dots. See how they maybe zigged here and zagged there and took a sharp turn and even moved backwards at times? But see how together they all move slowly and steadily forward from that first decision you made long ago to graduation today. Note how along the way the zigs and zags grew smaller as you gained self-confidence and acquired new liberating ideas and skills. The picture that emerges today is not of a child's kitten or flower or dog, but a portrait of a strong, determined, and seasoned winner. By learning to connect the dots, you discover just who you are and what you can accomplish. So, congratulations. Now, when you wake up tomorrow and the balloons have gone flat, and maybe the dishes are still in the sink, and the dog is eating the leftover cake, get up and look out the window of the future. Notice there are no dots. No counselors to guide you on, you're on your own. What kind of dots will you put in that blank future? Dots for more college, for success in business, for wealth, power, for healing, teaching, for justice, for equality? Now remember this, anybody can put dots in your future, but only a few, like you, have the self-discipline to connect them. So as you begin this new momentous journey, choose well and wisely. And remember, in spite of inevitable twists and turns, connect all your dots and stars and dreams and trust in yourself. Let the rush of excitement, of pride, amazement, and accomplishment you feel today carry you far into a future full of wonder, surprise, and success. Congratulations and good luck, College of Alameda Class of 2013, and always stay connected. Thank you.
The next individual that I'd like to introduce is new to Peralta, but not really. He is our chancellor, Chancellor Jose Ortiz. And Chancellor Ortiz, when I first came to the district in 2004, was a vice president of instruction at Laney College, and I was the vice president of instruction at College of Alameda. Little did I realize that he would come back and be my boss. If I had known that, I would have been a little bit nicer to him. So without further ado, I'd like to introduce our chancellor, Chancellor Jose Ortiz. And Chancellor Ortiz will also introduce our Chancellor's Trophy nominee.
Good afternoon, everyone. I want to share with you my congratulations to the graduates this evening. I want to congratulate parents and friends who supported all of our graduates. I want to congratulate the faculty for all their hard work, and we're seeing the fruit of their work today as we celebrate the accomplishments of our graduates. I know you'll have plenty of speakers here today. So what I want to do at this moment is talk about the Chancellor's Trophy Award. About 35 years ago, the Peralta District established the Chancellor's Trophy, an award that each college considers for the most outstanding student who demonstrates a combination of scholastic achievement, citizenship, leadership, and community service. And for the College of Alameda, the 2013 Chancellor's Award Trophy goes to Lolo Regan. Lolo, you here? Come on up here, Lolo. Come on up here, Lolo. Lolo, stand next to me. Stand next to me, young man. Lolo is a political science major, and his professional goals are to study law and to become an attorney. Of course, we need a few more of those. Some of his community activities include serving as a law firm translator for asylum cases, and working to educate the community and life in Haiti after that devastating 2010 earthquake. He's also involved with a social movement in Haiti that provides impoverished street children with free education who would otherwise receive none. Lolo has achieved many academic honors, and he is a member of the Phi Theta Kappa Honor Society. Lolo has overcome great personal, academic, and economic challenges to stand here before you today as a true leader and inspiration to all of us, certainly to our students, and to our community. Lolo is graduating with a 3.62 GPA. I know he's smart, but he's not that smart, right? Although he told me he was smart. Anyway, we want to wish Lolo congratulations, much success in his future endeavors, education, and profession. And today, the Chancellor's Trophy is around here somewhere. I think it went with a 6.2 GPA, but anyway, there's a cash award for Lolo. And please join me in congratulating Lolo for his accomplishments. Thank you very much.
Well, thank you for your round of applause. I got to thank the chancellor and the staff here in College of Alameda that basically, you know, supported me through the long journey, and that's not the end of it. There's more to come, but this part of it is definitely over. Thank you so much.
Thank you. College of Alameda has three tenets, and those tenets are what I call our ABCs: academic excellence, budgetary competence, and community collaboration. Integral to these three tenets are the contributions of our faculty, our staff, and our students. Here to speak to you today and offer their congratulatory remarks are Bob Grill from the Academic Senate, Paula Armstead for the Classified Council, and Pablo Forrest, President of the Associated Students. And if they would come up in that order, we would thank you.
Hi, I'm Bob Grill. My students and friends know me as Cousin Bob, and I'm President of the Academic Senate. As Senate President, I've given 7 speeches over the years. Most were short, somewhat entertaining, and forgettable. Topics like commencement being ironic as being both an ending and a beginning, what employers are looking for in employees, having a good work ethic, being able to work in groups, or this regalia we're wearing. Why are we dressed up like clerical robes from 600 years ago? As this is my last speech, in fact, my last real duty as Academic Senate President, I've thought of 2 topics I'd like to share with you. The first comes from discussions I've had over the last few years. At this ceremony, who are the most important people in the room? And no offense to anybody on the dais, but it's not the board members, the chancellor, administrators, faculty, staff, or even the graduating class themselves. If you ask me, the most important people in the room, it's the children of the graduates that are the first in their families that went to college. We're changing society here. You are changing society. Now your kids know college is not a goal for someone else. If they see their mom, dad, uncle, cousin, grandparent went to college, walked across this stage, they're learning here now that this is something for them as well. By being here today, you're changing the future of our community for the better, improving the lives of the next generation. It's a big deal, and you should be really proud of yourselves. The second topic is more personal. Being closer to the end than the beginning of life, and thinking a lot about what life has taught me, it's to follow your bliss. Find out what your bliss is. What makes you happy? What brings you great joy? Make it your life's work to be able to say, oh boy, I get to wake up and go to work, instead of, damn, I have to get up and go to work. Be that person and have a happy life. It's more important than being rich. I know rich people who work really hard to make money so they can take vacations to get away from the work they do every day. They don't know their bliss. I wouldn't trade with them for all their riches, and some of them are really rich. But they're not happy. Now, there is a pragmatic reality here that we can't forget. Get that entry-level job. Keep looking up for the next one. Remember lifelong learning. We'll be here for you to keep on training so you get that next job at a higher wage. But most of all, follow your bliss. So on this commencement day, the last day of school, first day of the rest of your life, and in these 15th century clerical robes, I say congratulations to the class of 2013. Get those jobs, model life for your kids, and follow your bliss. Thank you.
As president of the Classified Council, I represent the staff members here at COA. The employees and admissions that assisted you with registration and transcripts, the staff in the dean's office that helped you, the DSPNS staff that sat with you in the lab, and the financial aid staff who processed them checks. Mm-hmm. Right. On behalf of all of us, we would like to congratulate the class of 2013 on your remarkable achievement. Today marks the culmination of all your hard work and perseverance. Embrace this moment because you've stayed the course and are now seated on the other side. Your work here is completed. For some, you've overcome adversity in your own lives. You've all gained knowledge, explored new opportunities, ideas, and concepts. You've established relationships. You're now in a position to take on new challenges and chase bigger dreams. Whatever plans lay ahead, whether it's furthering your education, seeking employment, maybe the armed forces, or starting your own business, we wish you success as you embark on this new chapter in your lives. Congratulations, class of 2013, and God bless you all.
Friends, family, loved ones, presidents, deans, and distinguished guests, and of course, graduates, welcome to the graduation ceremony for the College of Alameda class of 2013. As student body president of College of Alameda, I'm here to represent the students and to congratulate them. All the students here before you, draped in their caps and gowns, got here through hard work and sheer determination. What we have accomplished is no easy task, not when a student comprises of several other important roles. We are all sons, daughters, brothers, sisters, significant others, mothers and fathers. Some of us hold down two jobs while we go to school full time. Graduates, take pride in what you have accomplished. Know now that you are a role model to future generations. Take pride in the idea that with you being here, you may have inspired someone in the crowd here to support you to continue on their long road of education. Take pride in the idea that you may have inspired someone else to want to go back to school after years of not taking a single class. The future before you is all so much brighter now that you have reached your goal. Whatever your goal may be, perhaps with your AA degree you will jump onto the workforce, or perhaps you will begin a new chapter in your life in a 4-year institution in pursuit of a bachelor's or a master's degree. Whatever your goal, be proud of your involvement in this moment. All the years of sacrifices made, all the all-nighters orchestrated before a big exam, all the work you have put in culminates in this single moment of achievement and recognition. May all your endeavors be successful. May all you be prepared for the challenges and rewards life will surely bring to you.
I'm not sure if you noticed or not, but we have live music here at College of Alameda. And that is because of our musical director, Glenn Pearson. And so now he will entertain us with the musical interlude. And Miss Camaria Usley, I hope I pronounced that correctly, will lead us in song. So, Glenn, take it away.
Each day I give, I want to be a day to give the best of me. I'm only one, but not alone. My finest day is yet unknown. I broke my heart for every gain to taste the sweet. I face the pain. I rise and fall, yet through it all, one thing remains. Give me one moment in time when I'm more than I thought I could be, when all of my dreams are a heartbeat away and the answers are all up to me. Give me one moment in time when I'm racing with destiny. Then in that one moment of time, I will feel
Congratulations.
Oh, Camaria. Camaria Osley, thank you. That was fantastic. That was absolutely fantastic. The chancellor leaned over to me and said, boy, she's got a voice. Thank you so much. It is now my honor to introduce our keynote speaker. And if you want to follow along with me, her bio is in your program, but I'm going to start at the bottom and then go up to the top, rather than just doing it the way it's written. The Honorable Marie Gilmore, Mayor of the City of Alameda, is the daughter of immigrants from the Caribbean island of the Dominica. I know, I heard some woo out there in the back. Marie first moved to the Bay Area to earn a bachelor's degree from Stanford. She met her husband, Rod. And Rod, by the way, is on ESPN, if you watch that, Rod Gilmore, while they were attending the Berkeley Bolt Hall School of Law. They moved to Alameda in the 1980s to raise their children, Anthony and Nicole. And Nicole is also attending Stanford right now. Marie practiced law for several years before devoting her time to her family and the community. Rod, the son of a former Oakland City Council member and also a civil rights leader, Carter Gilmore. And I think that may be where she got a little bit of her inspiration. She's never said that, but that's what I think. Mayor Gilmore made history when she became the first African-American woman to serve as mayor of Alameda in 2010. Woo. Prior to becoming mayor, Marie first made local history when she was elected as the first African-American woman to the Alameda City Council, and that was in 2004. I'm not going to read all the rest of that. It's there for you to read, but it is my honor and my privilege. I consider her a friend to introduce you to Mayor Marie Gilmore.
Good afternoon, graduating class of the College of Alameda for 2013. It is truly my honor and my privilege to be here. And I'm honored to be here with the other honored guests, faculty, staff, parents, and everybody in your life who cares about you and who has supported you up to the time that you have reached this very, very special moment. And make no mistake, this day, this moment, is about you, the graduates. We're here to celebrate your achievements. This day would not be happening if it weren't for your dedication and your hard work. All of you had different reasons for enrolling in the College of Alameda and working very hard to reach this day. Some of you are here for career technical education classes, such as aviation, automotive, and dental assistance. Some of you are here for a more academic sort of preparation as you may transfer to another institution. And some of you are here, in addition to all of those things, for personal achievement and enrichment. But every single one of you are going to leave today with critical life skills, a better understanding of the world around you and your place within it. Throughout your time here, you have garnered the tools to live more effectively in our very complex world and be able to handle the challenges that are unique to living in our time. But before you set out to face those challenges, find those jobs and those career enhancements, I want to talk about three things, and Cousin Bob stole the first one. I was going to talk about passion. He called it following your bliss, and I can't say it any better than he did. So I'm going to move on to my second thing, which is opportunity. Some of you may sit here today and know exactly what you want to do. Others of you are still struggling to find your way. But whichever group you land in, always be alert to opportunity, because opportunity will strike when you least expect it and in a manner that you don't expect. When I first became mayor, somebody said to me, "So, is this the culmination of many years of planning? Is this something you wanted to do?" And I could honestly say, no, it wasn't. I did not set out on this road to become mayor. It happened. I was able to see opportunities at every different stage and say, this is interesting, this is a challenge, I want to do this, I don't know how it's going to turn out, but I'm going to give it my best shot. And here I am today. And so I urge each and every one of you to be on the lookout for opportunity, and when it comes, to seize it with both hands. The other thing I want to talk about very quickly is to become engaged. Become engaged in your community, however you define that to be, whether that's your work community, your school community, where you live. They say all politics is local, and that is so true. It's obviously very important to register to vote and vote for president. It's also extremely important to vote in your local elections, because those are the decisions that more directly affect you. As I tell my children, there are two reasons why you should vote. One is because people have died in the past and people are still dying today, to ensure that you have this gift of democracy. And the other reason, a lot more prosaic, is if you don't vote, you can't complain. The other thing is that you have been blessed with the gift of education. You have worked hard for it. You have something to give back to your community. I believe that it is our duty and privilege to reach down, reach back, reach forward, and help those who are not as fortunate as we are. And everybody has something to give. You may not think so, but you do. People will look up to you. People do look up to you. You have to keep passing the torch. It's very important. So I just want to say to the graduating class of 2013, best of luck as you continue on your journey. Remember to be passionate. Look for opportunities and engage yourself fully in your community. Work hard, play hard, love much, and give back. Thank you very much.
First of all, I want to thank Mayor Gilmore for being here. She fit this into her schedule. She had to make changes, and I work with her secretary to make sure that she would be here, because I think it was important, and I want to thank her for that. But we do have a little token of appreciation.
Oh, thank you so much. You did not have to do this.
Yes. Yes, we did have to do this. We want you to know we appreciate you. Thank you very much, Mayor Gilmore.
Thank you very much.
It's now that time in the program where we give recognition to different individuals here on the campus, including our students. In the past, we had a Employee of the Year Recognition Award, where we recognize the classified professional individual who truly epitomized selfless service. This year's award is going to an individual who I have mentored and am so proud of, because she has done so much. You've probably seen her bubbling around the campus. She's got her bachelor's degree, she's got her master's degree, and she gives so much. I would like to bring to the stage, in fact, she's already on the stage, the classified vote this in. This isn't something that I make the selection of. And they voted in this year the classified employee of the year, Ms. Paula Armstead. And this time we do have the check.
Oh, I got money. I got my check.
The check, Lolo. We do have a check for you too, but we do have a check right here, so
mine
thank
is on
you.
Stage.
Hers is on stage. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dr. Jackson.
You want to say it?
No, I don't.
The College of Alameda held its 30th annual award ceremony May 16th at the Elks Lodge here in Alameda. We honored scholarship recipients, our outstanding athlete scholars, and our student leaders. Some of this year's scholarship recipients are listed on the last page of this year's commencement program. In fact, some of you that are sitting in the graduating class hopefully have found your name there. All of you also may have noticed in the program that there are students listed as candidates for associate degrees who have italicized H's after their name. The H's signify students who are graduating with honors, with high honors, and with the highest honors. And I'd like to tell you what that means. Honors for students who have a GPA of 3.25 to 3.49, those are considered honor students. High honor students are those that have a grade point average of 3.5 and 3.74, and this is the entirety of their time at the college. And then our students graduating with the highest honors are those who have a grade point average of 3.75 to 4.0. And I'd like for those individuals to stand and be recognized. Those students that are graduating with honors, please stand for applause. Academic excellence. Those students that are graduating with high honors, please stand. And those students that have had a B+ or an A throughout their tenure with the highest honors, would you please stand and be recognized? Thank you. You may have noticed that two individuals that are students that are in the same gowns as those of you stood on the dais, and I'd like to recognize them. Our salutatorian for the class of 2013, Tran Nguyen, would you please come forward and be recognized? Tram is graduating with a 4.0 GPA. She doesn't know what a B looks like. In the fall of 2013, Tram will attend San Francisco State University, where she will enter the very prestigious nursing program. Tram is the first generation college graduate in her family and is the winner of the College of Alameda Faculty and Staff Scholarship.
Thank you. Thank you, Tram. Oh, look. Thank you. can be seated. Do you want to say something?
Everybody say no, no. Okay. Our valedictorian, who also stood up when I asked people to stand up with honors, Christine Rortak. Did I get it right this time? I'm close. Pretty close, pretty close. Come on up, Christine. Christine is the valedictorian for the class of 2013 and will be graduating from College of Alameda with a, what did I just say? A 4.0. She is a member of Phi Theta Kappa. She lives in Alameda, and she has been married for 8 years. Doesn't look like it. She's young. Christine is a dance instructor at Dance 10 Performing Arts Center. Every year, Christine performs in Disneyland's California Adventure Park and with the Dance 10 Company. She ran the Alameda Mayor's 4th of July 5K last year, Mayor Gilmore, and she plans on running in this year's race. Christine will receive an Associate of Science degree in Natural Science. Next fall, Christine will enter San Francisco State University, where she expects to earn a bachelor's and a master's degree in health education. Please join me in recognizing our valedictorian. The stage is, it's okay. Your turn, Christine.
Whew. A journey. Greetings, Honorable Cy Glossa, President of Peralta Board of Trustees, Dr. Ortiz, Chancellor of Peralta Community College District, Jeanette Jackson, President, College of Alameda, and honored guest, my mayor, the Honorable Marie Gilmore, Mayor of the City of Alameda, faculty, staff, parents, friends, and family, and fellow graduates of the class of 2013. When I was growing up in Stockton, California, the first of 11 grandchildren, my grandparents took care of me and instilled in me responsibility, love, reliability, compassion, determination, and accountability. Though my grandparents never thought they'd raise another child, they made sure I received the best education and kept me out of trouble by promoting my love of dance. Today, as I look to my future, as many of you have been doing, I am looking for an opportunity to give back and care for my family and community. In my community, I am a pillar, tall, strong, and supportive. My students, parents, and fellow teachers and dancers look up to me, depend on me, and encourage me to reach for my goals. At Dance 10 Performing Arts Center in Alameda, California, I don't just teach dance. Through stretching and strengthening, I promote health and well-being with my students, the teens, and the adults. This is what being a caregiver in my community means to me. The dancers at the studio are my family in many ways, and they nurtured this sense of reciprocation. Together, we have performed for patients in assisted care facilities across the Bay Area, for patrons of children of Fairyland, and for members of the nonprofit organization Community Assistance for the Retarded and Handicapped. I have spent all major holidays with the studio, particularly Christmas, where as one of the infamous the tap dancing Christmas trees, we have traveled together to parades, tree lightings, and other holiday celebrations from Napa to the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade. I think it is my mission to inspire and motivate others to reach for their goals. In my 26 years as a dancer, and as I reflect on my educational experience, I have learned that our lives as dancers, students, teachers, nurses, parents, and partners take hard work and determination. A graduate day is an important milestone in a student's life and an opportunity to recognize not only achievements, but also the support we received along the way. I realized that growing up in Stockton and with my nurturing grandparents, they helped motivate me to live a life pursuing my dreams. I have learned that doing so brings richness to life, just much like how dancing has taken me many places. Paulo Coelho, author of The Alchemist, wrote, "When a person really desires something, all the universe conspires to help that person to realize his dream." 2 years ago, short on funds, but having won the opportunity to train as a Rockette in New York City, my Dance 10 family came together and donated their homes, time, and spirit to help organize a benefit to get me to New York City. Though I was attending school full-time and dancing 15 hours a week, my fellow dancers generally hosted me with a benefit cocktail party. Everything about the event was elegant and outstanding. I felt humbled to receive the support of those who attended, my family, my friends, and even complete strangers who heard my story and wanted to help out. I know that I'm cared for and appreciated in my community. They believe in me and encourage me to reach for my goals. As we stand on this stage, ready to go into the next chapters of our lives, I want to encourage you to pursue the dreams that are important to you, to strive for your particular greatness. I love my job and my community where I work, but perhaps like many of us, many of you are feeling, there's more to strive for. Through work and dance, I realize how important it is to help others achieve their goals. I look forward to furthering the greater good of humanity and helping to heal and care for my future patients. My next chapter will fuel my passions and provide the strength I need to be a pillar in my community for many years to come. May your next chapter do the same for you, and may all the energy in the universe conspire to help us do what we came here to do. Congratulations, my fellow graduates, the class of 2013. Thank you very much. Okay.
We also have an award for you. Now, you could never tell that Christine was a little nervous, could you? I could tell because she put her hand behind her and I could see it trembling a little. But let me tell you, you did a great job.
Thank you.
And you will do it again. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Before we proceed with the most awaited portion of the commencement, the presentation of diplomas to the graduates, I would like to take some time to recognize those in the audience that have supported our graduates. Could the wives, husbands, and significant others of the graduates please stand? Let me repeat that. Could the wives, husbands, and significant others of the graduates please stand and be recognized? Could the parents and guardians of the graduates please stand? Could the grandparents of the graduates please stand? Could the brothers and sisters of the graduates please stand? Could the relatives and friends of the graduates please stand? And it may take a little bit of effort to see this one. Could the children of the graduates please stand? Graduates, please stand and give a round of applause to all of your family, friends, and loved ones who have supported you and helped you to get to this momentous occasion. Thank you for your support of our graduates. Finally, we want to especially recognize those graduates that are the first in their families to graduate from college. Please stand. So ladies and gentlemen, we've now come to the most awaited portion of our ceremony. At this time, we will begin with the awarding of degrees and certificates. Coming forward to take her place on stage will be Dr. Jeanette Jackson, President of the College of Alameda. Announcing our graduates this afternoon will be Truly Thompson, President-elect of the Academic Senate, and Paula Armstead, President of the Classified Council. Ushers, please take your places and prepare for the awarding of degrees.
Spencer De Leon, Associate of Arts degree with a major in Political Science.
Jacqueline Jackson, Psychology and Sociology, Associate degree.
Ms. Sharifa Sparks, Associate of Arts degree in Business Administration.
Robert Mitchell, Associate degree in Human Services.
Laura Lozano, major sociology.
Wandasia Smith Lewis, major in liberal arts and social behavioral sciences.
Cecilia Brooks, AA liberal arts, behavioral and social science.
Ms. Fatima Oliver, Associate Degree, Behavioral Social Sciences.
Mr. Jonathan Rivers Stepney, Major in Art.
Abiodun Apata, Business Administration Major.
Essie Brooks, Liberal Arts, Social and Behavioral Sciences.
Dijon Starks, Liberal Arts, Social and Behavioral Sciences.
Manny Flores, Liberal Arts, Social and Behavioral Sciences.
Give it up.